Hello everyone, welcome back. This lecture is in continuation to the stability of four-wheel vehicle to take the turn. So in that lecture we discussed and we find out the reaction forces on all four wheels, and we discussed the gyroscopic effect on the four-wheeler while it's taking a turn. So because of that gyroscopic couple, we find out the reaction force on the wheels, and that reaction was acting on the upward direction on the outer line wheels. These were the outer line wheels, and this was the inner line wheels. This is front line, and this was rear line, and vehicle was taking a left turn, and it was moving with V velocity. So in this we discuss that reactive gyroscopic couple is 4iw omega w omega p plus minus. This was the effect because of the engine. Here this is mass moment of inertia of engine, and this is the angular velocity of the engine, and this was the precession velocity, that was V by capital R. R capital R is the radius of curvature of track, and this was the linear velocity of vehicle. So here plus minus, this sign we considered in this engine was rotating in the same sense. Suppose this is the direction of observing, if this is the observer, and engine is rotating in the same sense as wheels are rotating in clockwise direction, and engine is also rotating in the clockwise direction, we take the plus sign here, because this was the effect because of the engine, and this is the add up in the gyroscopic effect because of the wheels. Wheels are also rotating in the clockwise direction when viewing from this side. This is the observing side. Observer is here. So, and if wheel is this engine is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, if this is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, then we take this negative sign here, because the effect of reactive gyroscopy because of the rotation of this engine is in the reverse direction of the gyroscopic effect because of the wheels. And this was the centrifugal coupled reaction. R centrifugal divided by 2 was the reaction because of the centrifugal force, and these were three reactions, this one, and this one on the outer wheels, these three, and this was the reactions on the inner wheels. So we, for stability, we put one condition that R on the inner wheels must be equal to greater than or zero. So from where we find out one condition that R because of weight must be greater than or equal to R because of gyroscopic R by 2 and plus R centrifugal divided by 2. So this was the condition for stability, and by using this equation we find out the critical velocity, critical linear velocity of vehicle for stability. But now, if the engine is rotating in this sense, these are the wheels and this is moving in this direction with V velocity and taking left turn. So if this is the direction of observer is here, we are this is the top view of vehicle, top view. So if this is the observer, these wheels are rotating in clockwise direction, and this is the engine, and it's, if we are viewing from the rear side, if we view from the rear side, this wheel is, this engine is rotating in clockwise direction. Let's consider the case where this engine is rotating in clockwise direction if we view from the rear side. Now, what will be the effect of gyroscopic, because of the gyroscopic effect on the reaction of the wheels? If this is the case, so because of the all wheels, the reaction would be the same, effect would be the same, but now this is the engine is located, or the orientation of engine is something like this. So this is the spin axis of engine. So now in this case, if we draw the angular momentum vector of this engine, suppose this is the angular momentum vector of engine LE, and if suppose this is our x-axis, this is y, and this is our z-axis, which is the axis of precession, precession axis. So this is precession axis, and this is axis of spin. And now if vehicle is taking the left turn, this would travel in this direction, and this would be the final direction after taking the 90 degree turn. This would be the L position of LE. So we can say this is the direction of active gyroscopic couple, active gyroscopic couple. So we can say this is the direction of reactive gyroscopic couple because of the engine, reactive gyroscopic couple because of engine. So if this is the reactive gyroscopic couple and we point out our thumb in this direction, the effect of this would be something like this. So we can say this reactive gyroscopic couple would act something like this. So this will try to lift up front wheels and try to push downward direction, pushing in the downward direction the rear wheels. So because of this, the effect, now we can say on the four wheels, this was the gyroscopic couple or reaction because of the gyroscopic, because of wheels, and now the engine is not oriented in this direction. So we can say if we draw the top view of vehicle, so there would be one reaction because of weight RW, and this would be the reaction because of R gyroscopic because of wheel, and this would be the R centrifugal, and this is divided by 2, and similar would be RW, R gyroscopic because of wheel, and this is R centrifugal divided by 2, and in this is R because of weight, this is R gyroscopic of wheel divided by 2, and this is R centrifugal divided by 2, and same RW, R gyroscopic of wheel, and R centrifugal divided by 2, and in this R gyroscopic would be only because of wheel 4 iw omega w omega p divided by 2 times of b. So here we were considering, in this case we were considering this part also because the engine was rotating in the same sense, but here we are not considering the, because engine is not rotating in the same sense. So rest, this would be the same, this would be the mg by 4 same as earlier, but now the reaction because of reactive gyroscopic couple of the engine, here this would try to, if this is rotating in the clockwise direction, this would try to lift up front wheels. So on the front wheel there would be a one more reaction, and that, let's say this is reaction, new reaction R gyroscopic because of engine, and let's say this is divided by 2. Now we'll calculate the value of this, and this would be new fourth reaction R gyroscopic because of engine divided by 2, and this will, this reaction will, this couple is trying to pushing lower or rear wheels in downward direction, so there would be one new reaction in the R gyroscopic because of engine divided by 2 and R gyroscopic because of engine divided by 2. Now let's say if the distance between the front wheel base and this is, let's say this is, this distance is D and this was B, wheelbase is B and this length of vehicle between these two axle is D. So now we know that tau E, tau reactive gyroscopy because of engine is LE multiplied by omega P, and we know that LE is IE omega E, this is omega P, and this is balanced by these reactions. So we can say R, the total reaction on the downward direction on the rear wheels is, let's say RGE, and total reaction on the front wheel is RGE. This is the total reaction on front wheels, or this is in downward direction, and this RG is total reaction on the rear wheel in the upward direction. This is the total reaction force in upward direction on rear wheels. So we can say this downward and this upward will form a couple, and this would be the exactly equal to the tau E. So we can say R gyroscopic because of E multiplied by D, this is the D, is equal to IE omega E omega P. So from here we can find out RGE, that would be IE omega E omega P divided by D. So if we put the value of RGE here, so this would be equal to, and this is divided by D. So here IE omega E omega P divided by 2 times of D, because total is RG, so on this is distributed over 2 wheels, so this is RG divided by 2. So similarly this value would be IE omega E omega P divided by 2 D, and this would be the in upward direction, and here also. So now in this case there would be a 4 reaction force on all 4 wheels. Now let's consider, if this engine is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, if we are viewing from the rear side and this engine is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, anti-clockwise direction. So now in this case, if we draw the, here let's say if we draw the angular momentum vector according to this situation, so this would be our angular momentum vector in this situation LE, and when it takes the left turn, then this would be travel in this direction, when anti-clockwise direction, this case was for the clockwise direction. So we can say in this case, this would be the direction of reactive gyroscopic couple, or this would be the direction of reactive gyroscopic couple. This would be the reactive gyroscopic couple when anti-clockwise direction. This would be the active gyroscopic couple when engine is rotating in anti-clockwise direction when viewing from the rear side. So now, if this is the reactive gyroscopic couple, we can say this will try to lift up. In this case, we can say if engine is rotating in anti-clockwise direction when viewing from rear side. So, and vehicle is taking left turn. So, in this case, we can say when viewing from, let's write it here, when viewing from rear side, engine is rotating in anti-clockwise direction and vehicle taking left turn. So in this case, this reactive gyroscopic couple would try to lift up the, or you can write, this would try to lift up rear wheels and pushing in downward direction. To the front wheels. So we know that if it's try to lift up the rear wheels, this reaction would be in downward direction. So RG reaction because of gyroscopic couple, because of engine divided by 2, would be in downward direction if engine is rotating in anti-clockwise direction when viewing from rear side, and this was when engine was rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Similarly, there would be a reaction in downward direction, RGE divided by 2, in downward direction when engine is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, and on the front wheels the effect would be just reverse. So we can say this would be in RGE divided by 2 would be in upward direction if engine is rotating in clockwise direction, and this would be in downward direction if it's rotating in clockwise direction. So we can say similarly here, this RGE would be in upward direction if engine is rotating in anti-clockwise direction when viewing from rear side, and this is in downward direction if engine is rotating in clockwise direction. So now we can say in this case, each wheel is having 4 reaction force, and again we can say in the inner side wheels only 2 can be in upward direction and 2 can be in downward direction. So wisely we have to choose on which wheel we can apply the condition of stability. So the wheel which will have the minimum reaction force or maximum downward reactions, because of the weight, reaction is always in upward direction, and because of gyroscopic and centrifugal, gyroscopic because of wheel and centrifugal because of wheel is always in the downward direction. If it's moving in forward and left side, then it's on the inner wheel, this reaction would be in the downward direction, but because of gyroscopic couple of engine, this can be in upward direction or can be in downward direction. It depends on the, if the engine is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, the reactive gyroscopic couple, because of the engine, the reaction would be in the upward direction. If the engine is rotating in the clockwise direction, this would be in the downward direction. So now out of these two inner wheels, we have to choose the one and we can apply the condition of stability. So out of all four wheels, we can choose the wheel which is having minimum reaction force to derive the stability condition. And stability condition is R on the wheel in this direction must be equal to greater than or equal to 0. So out of 4, if anyone is lifted up from the ground, then vehicle will not be stable. So wisely we can choose out of these 4, anyone can be lifted up. And in this case, out of inner wheel, because rest all 3 direction are in the similar manner, but only one direction, because of the reactive gyroscopic couple of the engine, there would be a in the different direction. So if this is in downward direction, we can choose this wheel. If this is in the downward direction on the front wheel, we can choose this wheel. So we can apply the stability condition similar in the earlier manner. So thank you.